Sairam. With pranams at the lotus feet of Bhagavan, very nice to be amongst you for the fourth session on Sai Pearls of Wisdom, covering the conversations of Bhagavan, the students and teachers in the veranda of Prashanthi Nilayam. We could cover up so far October and September to the best of my knowledge. But anyway, those who are yet to be covered are many. We pray Bhagavan to give us sufficient time and strength so as to keep every one of you informed what Swami talks to students on different topics, on different occasions. Well, let me take up the month of June 2002. June 2002. Here we have many references to the summer classes which were held in the last week of May. Some of the comments of Bhagavan I noted during that time and started sharing them in the month of June. So we may have conversations of Bhagavan during the month of June 2002. Well, now, it was a bright sunny day and Bhagavan was just on his way for giving darshan to devotees seated there in Sai Ramesh Hall. He noticed everybody and instructed all teachers and students and guests to move over to the college auditorium where summer classes were held, as you know. Yes, the sessions were interesting. And in the evening, Bhagavan, as usual, came for the divine discourse. As you know, every evening Bhagavan used to give a discourse to all students and teachers and the devotees every evening. That evening he was proceeding towards the dais. Then immediately he stood in front of an elderly gentleman. Here the name is not important. The event is important. He stood in front of an elderly gentleman who wears Indian dress of this state of Andhra Pradesh. You know dhoti? The pandits wear dhoti and also a lalchi. You know that. He stood in front of that gentleman and said, "Hey, this morning I saw you with vermilion, with a dot on your forehead, and that too of plastic. And now you are having the vermilion of kumkum. This morning you had plastic, and this morning kumkum. Why difference?" he said. I was wonderstruck, because I know this gentleman sitting behind, far behind in the auditorium. Must be 50th row or 60th row. This good God notices the plastic dot on his forefront and tells in the evening, "Why the difference?" Well, as usual I said, "Swami, how is that you notice that small dot on the forehead, the vermilion? I know this gentleman sitting far behind. What is all this? This is very mysterious." Swami laughed and said, "Nobody need to tell me anything. Nobody need to tell me anything. Everything comes under the purview of my notice and observation. Everything will come to my notice. Nobody need to tell me. This is really a revelation." And on some other day, Bhagavan just turned to me and asked me, "How do you like my discourse? How do you like my discourse?" God wanting human comment on his discourse. Well, it is really a matter of fortune, matter of good luck, to have been privileged to comment on the divine discourse to God Himself. Well, then I said, Swami, your talk is fantastic. All our doubts are dispelled. All our doubts are clarified. Thank you, Swami. It's a beautiful discourse. Then Bhagavan said, you want me to believe that? No. Your body is full of doubts. Top to toe. They will never be clarified. Then I said apologetically, Swami, if my body is full of doubts, which can never be clarified, what am I to do? What is my fate? What is my destiny? Destiny in Sanskrit is called gati. Gati. I said, Swami, what is my gati? What is my destiny? What is my fate? If I am full of doubts that cannot be clarified, what am I to do? Then Bhagavan said, what? Repeat your question. I said, Swami, what is my gati? What is my fate? He said, Sharanagati is the solution. Sharanagati meaning surrender. You surrender to me, Sharanagati. That is your gati, that is your destiny. That's what Bhagavan has said. So my friends, the only gati, destiny for all of us is Sharanagati. Surrender to God. This is a nice statement that I wanted to share with you. Then, another day, I'm talking to you all the events that have happened in the month of June. This is the third episode. Bhagavan, while moving among students, he looked at one boy and he said, where do you come from? Where do you come from? That boy said, Swami, from Bangalore. Oh, I see. Then Bhagavan immediately said, how is your father? Bhagavan wants to know where he comes from. The next question is, he wants to know about his father. I don't know why all this. Why all this curiosity? Why all this inquisitiveness? And then Bhagavan put another question to the boy. What is your father, boy? That boy said, Swami, my father is a lecturer in Hindi, working in Swami's college in Bangalore. All of you know that I served as the principal of Bangalore campus for 6 years. I know all of them. Then I was immediately shocked. Your father there in Bangalore? I must be knowing him. Then what is his name? Before that boy opened his mouth, God started speaking. His father's name is Suresh Chand Jain. Suresh Chand Jain. Oh, Swami. Then Baba said, you know what happened 20 years ago? 20 years ago. What happened, Swami? His father was going on motorcycle with this little boy at a high speed and met with an accident. The whole motorcycle is smashed, but nothing had happened to the boy and the father. He is the very same boy, you understand, he said. This is an incident which I want all of you to look at it from this angle. Just because Swami asks, where do you come from? That does not mean that he doesn't know where we belong to, where we come from. He knows. But to give us the satisfaction of being spoken to give us the joy of being spoken to, he makes such enquiries. Because here is a typical example.
Where do you come from? What is your father? Then tells what had happened 20 years ago. See that. One is an inquiry, other is a revelation. Inquiry for your satisfaction, revelation as an expression of His divinity. Really, we were all wonderstruck that day when Swami explained what all that had happened. Then, the fourth episode. Boy's results were awaited that day. Results were not announced, but Baba just started talking to boys and he said to one boy, look here, your other brother is studying in Bangalore campus. You are studying in Prashant Nilayam campus. I know both of you. And your sister is Anantapur campus. I know her also. And your brother got O grade. And you got only A grade. Then I thought, Swami, you know his brother and sister, I know everybody. Not only the students here, I know everybody all over the world. I know the students, their brother, their sister, their parents, forefathers, everybody I know. And then, this is an important statement that Baba said. Turning to boys, he said, "Re boys, you are so young, you don't understand me. You think that I am not talking to you. You think that Swami is not looking at me. But I know everybody. I know the members of your family. I know your marks in every subject." Yes, that's what I know. That's what Bhagavan has said. And in fact he said, never feel that you are away from Bhagavan. Never feel that I am not talking to you. I may not talk to you. I may not look at you. But I know every detail of everyone here. That's what Bhagavan has said. Then, another fifth episode, this is what had happened. Swami, that morning, was talking to a student of MBA class. He did his engineering and now doing MBA, business management. And Swami looked at him and said, "Hey, you boy, you applied for a job." I know. But you didn't get it. That also I know. Then I said, Swami, when once you know, why did you not see that he gets a job? Why do you say that he didn't get a job? Then Baba turned to that boy and said, shall I tell him what had happened? That boy said, Swami, please. I will tell. Then Swami said, you know, this boy did not fill up the application form. The application form was filled up by his mother. So he didn't get the job. Your mother can't fill up the application form on your behalf. You have to fill up the application form. So, never do that, Baba said. If you want to apply, you fill up the application form yourself. Don't ask anybody. And then he said, if you are hungry, is it enough if your mother eats on your behalf? If your leg is broken, your mother can't have bandage. No. You have to put bandage for yourself. So, each one has to work for one's own liberation, for one's own salvation, for one's own moksha. We cannot ask somebody else to do it on our behalf. This is an important note that Swami has said. Then, the sixth. It was a cloudy day. Cloudy. Clouds all over. And it started raining also. Bhagavan looked at the clouds.
And he said, stop.
Stop.
And told all boys, don't worry. They are only passing clouds. They won't rain. Everything will be perfect. Believe me or not, the rain stopped immediately. When he said stop, that ends the matter. Why? Whom has he asked to stop? Maybe the rain god. Maybe the clouds to stop their business, that's all. Immediately stopped. And it's a matter of knowledge, awareness to all of us to know that Baba is the master of the five elements. He can control rain, he can control fire, he can control any of the five elements. Most of you know, most of you must have heard it. Well, I am a witness to that. Many times it so happened that it rained everywhere in Puttaparthi, but not in Prashantinilayam. But not in Prashantinilayam. Many times it happened that rain started only at the end of the discourse when all devotees returned home. When all devotees dispersed, when they all have returned to their homes, then rain starts. It happened many times. I am a witness. So Bhagavan controls all the elements, five elements. Most of you must have also come to know as a miracle that Indra Devi said in her book, where there was a fire everywhere, all over in Los Angeles. And this lady was conducting yoga classes. And Indra Devi said, we are helpless now. Fire around. Just sit down where you are. Chant Sai Ram. They are all chanting, Om Sri Sai Ram, Om Sri Sai Ram. What happened? After 10 minutes, fire got extinguished on its own. Many things have happened around, but the building where they stayed is safe and secure. It is a proof to say that Baba is the master of all the five elements. Now the seventh cousin, talking in sequence, there is one student. You must have observed there. He is a boy of Sikhism, Sikh philosophy. Not S-I-C-K. It is S-I-K-H. Guru Nanak. Because when I said he is a Sikh boy, don't think that he is hospitalized fellow. No. Sikh, S-I-K-H. Sardarji. Sardarji. You must have seen. There is one student. That day, Swami asked that boy to speak. That boy started speaking. Well, Sikhs, they have very good body. Wheat eating place. Most of them are there in the north, in the border areas, protecting this country, well built. And that boy said in his talk, this way, 23 years ago, an old lady visited this Prashantinilayam along with her little grandson. Why? To receive Baba's blessings. What happened there? Doctors said that this little grandson had a hole in his heart. And that little child must be operated upon. And so, doctors also said that this little boy, grandson, had no hopes of survival, even after operation. So this old lady, grandmother, went on praying to God, Swami, you should save my grandson. Because doctors said, situation is critical. And all doctors confirmed it is a heart complaint. Swami blessed gave vibhuti, that little child, and he got cured because of vibhuti. That little boy has grown up and he completed his schools, he completed his college studies, and that little boy is the one talking to you now, he said. The one whom you see now is the very same boy who got himself cured of the heart disease 23 years ago. Then I came along with my grandmother. That is the power of Sai Vibhuti. And further, as I said, most of the Sardarjis are army people. He said, thumping his chest, "Look here, I declare Guru Nanak and Sai Baba are one and the same." The head of Sikh philosophy, Guru Nanak and Baba. Yes, I say that, I declare it. All clapped in joy. And then Swami said, "Hey boy, nice talk. Good. I know your father is in Kashmir area. Now, lot of fighting is going on. Don't worry, I'll take care of him. Don't worry." And then turned to every one of us and said, "Hey, poor fellows, do you think there will be war now?" "No, no. No war will take place now. Don't be afraid of that. It is only a kind of threat, war threat, but not actual war. Nothing will happen to your father. He will come for Swami's darshan next month. Don't worry." That's what Bhagwan told him. Be happy. This is an incident of the miracle of the boy and Swami's blessing to the boy's father. They're working in the border area, protecting this country. Now, we think of the 8th episode. He asked another MBA boy, his name is Shashank, boy from MBA. That boy spoke in front of Swami for the first time. Quite fair enough, with big eyes, nice to look at, and boy from the city, delicate, quite sensitive, well-dressed, handsome too. And he went on talking like this: "I wanted to be a student of such a Sai University. It has been my long cherished dream and a desire. But I could not get seat admission all these years, though I really wanted to be here. There is one genuine reason. I am a student of Bombay University. And after the examination, by the time results are announced there by the Bombay University, classes will begin here in such a Sai University. So I have no chance to apply. Because examination should be over there. Results should be published there. Then only I can apply. Then only it is possible to join here. So, it could not be possible. I was very desperate. I was very much disappointed." Then that boy said, "Look here, my friends. Bombay University has 5 lakh students on rolls. It's one of the very old universities in this country. In response to my prayers, for the first time, examinations are advanced. First time. In India, examinations are always postponed. Of course, boys want total cancellation. That's only a dream. It will never happen. But here, first time, examinations are advanced. So, he could write his examination, appear for entrance test, got the seat and could talk to everybody. Really, can you imagine a university advancing examinations? It never happens. Is it, believe it or not, it had happened. And boy says, the whole thing has happened because of my prayers to Bhagavan. Here, my friends, I may tell you my personal note here. I was traveling from Hyderabad by train, and I have got this weakness of forgetting the time when I start speaking about Swami. This is my weakness. But I can't help it. Too late to repent or correct. And I feel it's not necessary. Why? When devotees are so eager to hear me, when I have got so much of stuff with me, why can't I share after all? Doesn't matter. So, once it so happened, I was traveling by train, and somebody, the station master, said, "Anil Kumar, I heard that you gave a beautiful talk this evening in the city, and I could not attend the meeting because I am on duty. Why didn't you have some cup of coffee?" He asked me to get into his office, his air-conditioned office. Still some time for the train to arrive on the platform. So I was enjoying hot cup of coffee, and I always like hot cup of coffee. And I had cup of coffee, and then suddenly that man said, "What did you speak on? What was the topic?" That was enough for me. Then I started speaking. Suddenly that man looked at his watch and said, "Anil Kumar, I think it's time for the train. Let's go and check up." We both went to the platform. The train arrived and started leaving the platform. Arre, what a fool I am. The train left already. Then I told, "Sir, you are responsible. I have to wait for next train. That may arrive, may not. Trains always run late. That is punctuality. So what is it I can do?" Arre, poor man. That man said, "Don't worry, sir. Sir, it's nice for you to say don't worry. I have to bear the cross." I was feeling so bad. "Swami, please help me. Because I must go to the college. Please help me." To the best of my knowledge, never it happened. For the first time, the train started reversing. I never saw a train reversing. It came back and stopped. I got into the train. Yes? And then the train started moving later. "Baba, you are capable of reversing the train also." Huh? It had happened in my case, I'm a witness. Most of the people will tell you, if you talk to them, there is one place by name Kajipet near Hyderabad. All of them speak up of this miracle that happened. The train that left started reversing. That happens, yes. And the seventh, what happened was, Swami sat there on the chair with a bunch of letters. And then he said, "Pick up this letter," he said. "Pick up this letter." I picked up that letter. "See what is it there inside." I opened the cover. I saw a check for 37,500 rupees check. It is a check sent by a student to Bhagavan, his first month salary, as a token of love and gratitude. Swami said, "The boy who has sent the check is also here, but I don't tell his name. Because that boy will feel embarrassed. He will start crying. I don't tell his name. But look here, boys and teachers, I am telling you now. Hear me. I don't want your checks. I don't want your money. This is not the thing that I want from you. I want your love. I want your love, that's all. And this love is not your property. This love I gave it to you at the time of your birth. You are born with love. Why? It is my gift to you. So I want you to give me that which I gave you. Give it back to me, that's all. Not the money. I don't want anything. And then what happened? He tore the check. Number of pieces like that. He went on tearing. Then I laughed and said, Swami, one tear is enough. You don't need to make so many pieces like that. If you tear it once, that's enough. The check is invalid. Then he laughed. To let you know how I dislike these things. Therefore I am doing it. My friends, what is the position today in society? All over the world? Many gurus, they want money. Most of the gurus all over the world, they give discourses in the name of spirituality. They collect money. But here is a place, Prashant Nilayam, where there is only one God, by name Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba, who says, I don't want your money. No, I want your love. This is really unique. Then, the 10th episode. Here, in Satsai University, we have students of all religions. There are two Muslim boys. He called one boy. What's your name? He said some Muslim name. Good. He waved his hand and materialized the chain for him. Gold chain. At the center, there is crescent, half moon of diamonds and a star, which is the symbol of Muslims. Because this boy is a Muslim, he gave him the symbol of Islam faith. And then he looked at me and said, did you see that? Swami, I saw that. What did you see? Swami, I saw the crescent and the star, the symbol of Islamic faith. Come here. Take that. See what is written on the riverside? What is written on the riverside of the locket? It is written in English. Read it. Allah Bismillah. Allah Bismillah is written on the riverside. It means, have faith in God. And Baba said, you see, I encourage all religions are mine. I don't believe in conversions. I don't believe in changing your religions. Follow your own religion, you will reach me. That's what Bhagwan has said. And then he called another Muslim boy and he said, boy, are you feeling jealous that I gave him chain? Jealousy? He said, no, Swami, don't worry. He materialized ring for this boy. Chain for one Muslim boy, ring for another Muslim boy. Made everybody happy that day. That's the reason why during bhajans, we sing loudly, Sarva Dharma Priyate Va Satya Sai Deva Allah Yesu Buddha Nanak. Have you not heard that song? Sarva Dharma Priyate Deva. Oh God, all religions are yours. All religions are acceptable to you. That is the substance of that song. Let me share with you the 11th episode. One day, in the course of conversation, unknowingly, I committed a mistake. I said, "Swami, people of our region, of our area, don't act like this. Don't speak like this." I made a remark on one of the occasions. Then immediately Bhagavan said, "What? You say our area? My area? No, you should not say that. You belong to the whole world. You should not say my area, my region. Do you say that?" Then I said, "Swami, I am sorry. I will not repeat it. In fact, I want to give up this feeling of identification with the place where I was born. I am attached to my native place. I am sorry. I am trying to give it up." Swami said, "Trying? No. Try. It becomes dry. No trying. You must do it. And you must give up that regional feeling." "Swami, I'll do it." Then he said, "You know, when once you know that what you hold on hand is a serpent, what do you do? Do you play with it? Do you continue to hold it? No, you immediately drop it. Because you know, snake is poisonous. Similarly, when once you know this regionalism is bad, you should drop it immediately." That's what Bhagavan has said. It is in this context. It is a beautiful message to everybody. World is divided on grounds of religion, region, language, politics, narrow, silly, stupid considerations. In fact, we are all one. The whole world is one. We belong to the family of the universe. We are not separate. So Baba says, give up that regional feeling. You belong to the whole world. And that too, we should never say, "I will try to give up." No. You must do as the message, as Bhagavan has nicely conveyed. Now I move on to the 12th episode. It was the time when Bhagavan just returned from Bangalore after the summer course. And he was standing there. "Anil Kumar, you know why I am late? You know the reason for the delay?" "Swami, how am I to know?" "I don't know." Swami said, "On the way, I visited the home for the aged. And the local samiti people started a center for old people. And they're all staying there. I visited that center." And then Swami started speaking about it. "I spent 1 hour with the old people there. I gave them clothes, sweets. I joked, made everybody happy. So nice to hear, Swami. So nice." And then Swami started telling us few details. "Those people who are running the center there, home for the aged, are facing so many problems. There is some opposition from the locals. There are some people who are not cooperating." Then I said, "Swami, what is to be done then? what is to be done then? When local people pose a threat, a challenge to the authorities, how to run the center for the aged, center for senior citizens, how to run that? Or what in US you call young adults, if I am right, right? Young adults. Because no one wants to be called old after all. No one is old, no. All are young. Ever young. Young adults, that's all. So, Swami, what is to be done? Then Baba said, any good program will have to face the challenges. Because of opposition, you should not run away. Because of criticism, you should not be fear-stricken. You should resist all the problems, all the difficulties, all the obstacles and proceed ahead. You'll have God's blessings. This is a message to all of us that we should not be carried away by the blame, by the insults, by the assault or insult, whatever may be. Losses, criticism, whatever may happen. But in the name of God, we should start doing something good. And we are bound to be successful. Because there is God above who will bless our attempts. This is the 13th incident. One day, music started, darshan time, morning time. Well, I was late for darshan. What is to be done? My place, the place where I sit, though it is very convenient, though it is very good position, a vantage position, but it is an embarrassing position also. If you are late, I will be caught. That will be noticed. So, a very risky position. Seeing Swami started already there, music on, I ran. I didn't come in the front line. I started walking from behind. Across the veranda. Swami coming this way. And I was going that way. It's a management, you know. Then silently, slowly, softly, walking amongst, in between the devotees, cautiously, I sat at my usual place, adjusting my collar, just adjusting my hair, thinking that I was a very successful manager, if not manipulator. Our dear God started darshan, crossed the ladies' line, started moving among gents, slowly, slowly came towards us, stood in front of me and said, you are coming from behind. You came late and sat in the front. See, are you not ashamed to do it? Then I simply said, Swami, I thought that I would be able to escape from your notice. I thought that we would be able to manage. Then he looked, he smiled, laughed and said, your grandfather also cannot do it. Your grandfather also cannot escape from my notice, I tell you. You want to manage? Impossible. I will know whatever you do. Your intelligence is nothing. I can easily detect and find out. That's what Bhagavan has said. This I am reminded of a statement from Bhagavad Gita, which goes on to say, Bhagavad Gita, the song Celestial, which goes on to say that God's feet are everywhere, God's hands are everywhere, God's eyes are everywhere. God's ears are everywhere. So that he can hear, he can watch, he can go, he can pick you up. So, I could not escape the divine notice. So, I had to face the music that morning, along with the usual music. 14th. Well, I made a casual remark. Swami, the Andhra Pradesh government, state government, is trying to bring in some reforms in the Department of Police. You call them cabs in US, right? Constable, police people. Cabs. Anybody from US here? Cabs? Policemen? Cops? Oh, cops, yes. So, the Andhra Pradesh government is trying to make a change in the uniform of cops. That's what they say. And Baba said, oh, it is not enough if you change their dress. They should change their qualities. So dress change easy, but to change the qualities is tough. So I want you to change your quality, to change your mentality, not merely dress. That's what he said, which is also a lesson to all of us. 15th episode, with which we can close for this morning, I believe. If time is up, it is left to your discretion and better judgment. Bhagavan started speaking something special that evening. He said, out of so many students, few students are privileged. Few students are specially blessed because they stay with me at my residence. They sleep by my bedside. They sleep in the ante room. They are very, very close to me. And Bhagavan said, do you know that? Some people sit very close. They sit and sleep very close to my bedroom. One day, Bhagavan said, please listen to me carefully, attentively. Bhagavan said one day, these are the boys working in the super specialty hospital, Swami college students. One day, these boys got up in the midnight. What did they see? Only bed. Bhagavan was missing. Bhagavan was missing only bed. These boys started shivering. The body is literally shaken. And immediately the boys made other boys also get up. Where is Baba? Baba is not here. Only bed. Well, they all were talking and they were all very much surprised. Some of them started even crying. And immediately all of them gathered, about five of them, immediately went into the bedroom again. They saw Swami sleeping there in the bed. And another time what happened was, these are all I'm putting in the words of Sai, quoting him literally. And one time what happened was, Swami was resting there in another room, the boys were sleeping there in the ante room. They started hearing some conversation. Some conversation. Immediately they saw. Swami was talking to somebody. They did not see anybody. Swami was simply talking. They were very much surprised. What happened was, Swami said, my mother comes to me now and then. My mother comes to me now and then. I talked to her. These boys started wondering, with whom is he talking? We don't see anybody. And then these boys had many such experiences. They see me talking to somebody where there is nobody. They don't find me sometimes in the room. They have many experiences. and they cry quite often. But, this is an important statement, but I see to it they forget these experiences. I see to it that they forget these experiences. Then I said, why, Swami? Why should you do that? Baba said, if I don't do that, all newspapers will be publishing these experiences. The whole thing will go to the notice of everybody. I don't want it. That's what he said. Really speaking, if Swami allows these things to be known to the whole world, we will not have space there in Prashantanilayam. The whole world will start pouring in. And so, what I did was, Bhagavan, it is really surprising that you manifest, that you express to some, and you hide yourself to many. Bhagavan said, it is out of compassion towards you all. Because of compassion towards you, I see that many people don't understand me. It is also my leela. That's what Bhagavan has said. And then I will talk to you the 16th episode. This is month of July. From now on, we think of July episodes. Till 15th June 2002. From 16th July 2002. I thank you for giving me the printout of all Sai Pearls of Wisdom so that I also do sufficient homework arranging things in chronological order. I appreciate your earnestness, seriousness, inquisitiveness and deep interest to know these interesting conversations. It was the time of Guru Purnami. And then all preparations are going on in a hectic way. You also know this year we had exhibition there in the Hillview Stadium. Many of the foreigners, they had their own stalls. Many of the states from India, they had their own stalls there. I said, Swami, crowds are gathering here, population is increasing, swelling up day by day, as Guru Purnami is fast approaching. Swami said, good, good. You are not put to any inconvenience. Don't worry. You don't worry. You will not be put to any inconvenience. Let any number come here, he said. Then I said, Swami, somebody told me around 50,000 people are expected for Guru Purnima. Am I right? Then Bhagavan said, this very important statement, look here, you go by the numbers, by the count of heads, how many people are here? No. Tala in Telugu means head. You go by the count of tala, the head, talalu, heads. But I go by the talampulu, the thoughts. Talampulu, the thoughts. Talalu, the heads. You go by the count of heads, talalu, heads. But I watch talampulu, the thoughts of your heads, in your heads. This is an important thing. Swami is not carried away by the crowds or the number that gather. He goes by the feelings, by the thoughts of the devotees that come here. And further he made a remark. One spoon of cow milk is better than barrels and barrels of donkey milk. That's what he said. I am not for publicity. Even if there is one genuine devotee, it is enough for me. That's what Bhagavan has said. We'll proceed with the rest of the episodes of July 2002, having commenced one already the 16th. From 17th onwards, we'll continue in the next session. I am very, very grateful to you for this wonderful opportunity given to me in sharing these episodes with you. May Bhagavan bless you. Sai Ram, thank you very much.